Hello everybody, it's Niklas and welcome to this new video on Freecad. And in this video we are going to see how to create different shapes using the draft workbench. So I'm going to introduce different features of the draft workbench and how you can create shapes with different drawings tools. Subscribe to this YouTube channel, see if you like the content. First link on the description, the complete course Freecad is available. So if you want to learn Freecad step by step with a course structure, perfectly master this very great software, this amazing software, perfectly master different workbenches to create a drawing, to create 3D models, to make different things in Freecad, this course will be perfect. It is on the first link on the description. You will see the models, the sessions, what you will be able to learn to master Freecad. So let's start to do this. One of the first things to do is to go in the draft workbench here. So you can have access to the draft workbench. It is just a workbench that directly you can use. And what is the interest of this workbench? With this workbench, you can use different drawing tools and you can edit your drawing with different tools also. And if you want to add dimensions, to add a different annotation after, it's possible. One of the first things to do is to display the grid. So to display the grid, you can click here. And after to display the grid, you can set the grid that you want. You go on these panels. And you need to select what you want. So I'm going to select the top work plane. And after, you need to align the view on your element. So here, my grid is on the top view. So if you want to have the right alignment, I need to click on top. And it's extremely important to fix the view with the work plane that you choose. So when you go here, if you select top, you will have to work with the top view. If you select front, you will have to work with the front view. After, yes, for sure, you can stay like this. And if you want, you can, for example, use one of these tools and you can create your rectangle like this. But it's definitely not convenient to work like that. So I'm going to come back and activate top. So the work plane is top and I work on the top view. So what I'm going to do is to zoom a little bit. Here you can just unlock the snapping options and we can activate snap to grid. After to activate snap to grid, we have different tools to create drawings. So if I want to create a rectangle, for example, I click on my rectangles and here I will have different options. Something that I'm going to do is just first to use a grid. So you can just snap to the grid, create a first print, create a second print, and you can create a rectangle like this. If you want to create rectangles with entering point, you can click on these tools and you can enter the first point and the second point. You need to stay here. So for example, I can make a choice to define my first point at 10 on the x-axis and to define my second point at 10 on the y-axis. After, you need to click on enter point. Don't go on the right, because if you go on the right, now as you can see, it's coming back like that. So you need to enter the point, so I can tap 10 again on the x-axis and 10 again on the y-axis. And I can click on enter point. After that, my first point is located here. So as you can see, 10 on the x-axis, 10 on the y-axis. And now I can position my second point. So I can tap something here. Let's just tap, for example, 60 on the x-axis. And let's just tap 60 on the y-axis. And click on enter the point. And that's it. I created my rectangles just like that. I created my rectangles. And as you can see, this rectangles is the first point is 10, 10. The second point is 60, 60. And I created my rectangle using this point. You can do the same thing when you create a line. If I create a line, for example, I can define my first point. So my first point can be minus 30. And here minus maybe 10. So I can tap minus 30, minus 10 on the x and y axis. Why I don't work on the z axis? Because we work on the top work plane. I can click on enter the point. And now my starting point is here and I can position my second point. And to position the second point, I can just go on this area and x axis, I will tap maybe, I will tap 20. And y-axis, I will tap minus 6. just like that. And I can just click on enter the point also, but you can also enter length and angles. But if you enter length and angles, you will move the X and Y position. So whether you work on the second point, whether you work on length and angles, but not on the two at the same time, it's not useful. Enter the point. And as you can see, I created my second point for this line. So this is something that you need to understand. After, if you want to create, for example, circle, you can use the circle tools. And one more time, you can define a point. So if you want to start, for example, at 20, you can type 20 here. You can type also 20 here, enter the point. And now I can start at 20 and 20. And I can define a radius. If I want a radius of 30, I can type 30, press enter, and I created this circle with this different value. But if you don't want to use, you can just use a grid. You start, for example, from the center, and you can create a circle just using the grid. So definitely you can make a lot of things for drawing. For example, I will use my line tools, and I will zoom a little bit and create first line from this point to this point. And I will create a second line from this point to this point. I will create an arc. To create an arc, you have also arc tools. So for example, we have the arc tools here, arc and arc by sweep point. I will use the first one. I need to define the center. I will use my grid, this point, and you create a first point, a second point for the radius, and then a starting point and an end point. I'm going to show you again on the other side. I will use these tools. So first, this is the center point. Second, this is the radius point. After, you have the starting point and the end point. So starting point, end point. And I created this arc. I can complete with, for example, a circle just here. Let's create a circle with 6 mm and create a second circle with also 6 mm. I can just use my grid and I created this element, as you can see. Every time you will have different options. If you want to create a polyline, you have also the polyline tools, and you can create any polylines just like this here. And I can create something like that using the polyline tools. If I come back to my rectangle tools, every time you need to understand that you have different options. If I create a rectangle like this, if you want to select your rectangle, you don't need to select all the line. You just select one line and the rectangle is selected. When you go on view, here this is the view panels for example, the properties of the line. But we are going to focus on the detail panels. And on the detail, depending on what you choose, you have different options. For example, I can use a chamfer size like this. And as you can see, we have now a chamfer. If I want to apply a fillet radius, I can click on fillet and 4 mm. Now I have a fillet. But if you want, you can also mix the two, so you can apply chamfer like 6 and fillet 2. And you just click out, and now I have a chamfer mixed with a fillet, as you can see. And that's it. So every time you will have multiple properties on this area. You can come back to 0 on fillet, 0 on chamfer. You can also work with the height and the length of your rectangles, so you just need to change the value, and you can also work with the value here. You have also the possibility to make face, so when you click on make face, you can change for true, and in this case you can fill the shape with a face. Why it is useful? Because after you can mix with another workbench. So for example, you can use a part workbench, and from this face you will be able to create an extrusion or to do something different, but you will be able to use this face. If you want to come back, you click here, false. Something that you can do also, it is a placement. And to change the placement, you can go on this area, base, placement. And on base placement, you can select position. And with the position option, you can move your rectangle and enter the values that you want, depending of your work plane. So here on this work plane, I work on X and Y. I don't need to work on Z. But if you select something different, you can work on the Z axis also. So this is different type of tools that you can use here. And if you want to create, for example, a curve, you can use the spline tools. And you just need to create multiple points and you can position multiple points just like this. You can press Escape and you can finish your curves as you can see. So this is the type of things that you will be able to do with this workbench. So different type of drawing, you have different tools, even if it's possible to mix with other workbench also. So we are going to stop here for this video. If you like this content, subscribe to this YouTube channels. A lot of graphic content, 3D modeling content, CAD software. First link on the description, the complete course Freecad is available. So if you want to learn Freecad step by step with the course structure, it is on the first link on the description. This is a complete course, a lot of sessions organized in different modules. We see different workbenches. The aim is to master Freecad. So this course has a lot of hours of training sessions, and we see everything in details to perfectly master Freecad with different examples also. And for the next video here, see you. Ciao, ciao.